Gaius Armenteros on the tenor saxophone. Sherman Irby on the alto saxophone. Dan Nimmer on the piano. Winston Gonzalez on the trumpet. Thank you very much. So I'd like to turn it over now to an amazing, amazing musician sitting in the front row, and he has about 80 instruments in front of him, and you want to hear him play every one of them. And I always say this, you know, his father is one of the greatest trombone players in the world, and because of that, I don't know if it's because of that, but he writes some of the greatest trombone parts that you'd ever want to play. Mr. Ted Nash. Thank you very much.
Yeah, my father tried to get me to play the trombone, and I was pretty sad, so I just write for him. We can't talk about jazz ambassadorship and not mention the name Dave Brubeck. He was one of the incredible pianist and composer, obviously, but he was a true cultural ambassador. And Vince was talking about the State Department tours. He brought his famous quartet, the one with Paul Desmond and Eugene Wright and Joe Morello, to many places all over the world, like Eastern Europe and the Middle East and Asia, and did so much good. He not only inspired people there, but he was inspired so much by what he saw traveling around the world. And one thing so important about him was he consistently fought for racial equality throughout his life, both abroad and in the United States, and it was not popular to do so back then. He just a constant inspiration to all of us, his music, his playing, and his cultural ambassadorship. This piece that I arranged of his was inspired by the sound of a bird outside of his studio when he was composing this. It's called Strange Meadowlark. Thank you. trumpets, and Lucas on the bass. Yeah, give it. I'm going to pass it now to our next introducer, and this is one of the great members of the band in terms of like musicianship, composition, playing. He's an expert at mutes, and he is such a great guy. He's got the biggest ears. We also call him our band metronome. He's got perfect pitch. I'm talking about Chris Crenshaw.
Well, we talked about Dizzy Gillespie, we talked about Dave Brubeck. In their own right, they did so much for jazz. And this next gentleman also did the same thing in 50 years of uninterrupted greatness. We're talking about Duke Ellington. Duke Ellington, a DC native. Wrote, like I said, 2,000, over 2,000 compositions. And most of those compositions, if you mentioned about jazz ambassadorship, I think the state government, the State Department really benefited from him just going all over the country and all over the world. And he has his own musical passport, if you will, with suites like the Far East Suite, the Afro-Eurasian Eclipse, the Latin American suite, the New Orleans suite, even the U.S. suite that was written for the University of Wisconsin. And he did so much with, he and Billy Strayhorn did so much with music, and they did so much with the blues. And this next composition that we're getting ready to play has so many colors, harmonic colors in it, and it's definitely gonna take you on a trip. They recorded this back in 1959 on Groundhog Day morning. And Duke, at 2 a.m. during the session, they started the session at midnight. And around 2 a.m, they would go on break and Duke would have some steak, grapefruit cut in half, a large jar of coffee, and a lemon cut in half. So that was, you could say that was his early breakfast. Or late dinner, whatever you prefer. But this is called Blues in Orbit. Hope you enjoy Blues in Orbit. It's gonna feature the saxophone section. It's also gonna feature Marcus Printup on trumpet and Dan Nimmer on piano.
Thank you.
Yeah, that's how they play Milwaukee. That's how they play piano out in Milwaukee. Yes. I'll turn it back over to Nelson Gardner to introduce this next Dizzy Gillespie composition.
So returning to the music of Dizzy Gillespie, we'll go back to his 1940s big bands. And this one is a piece that commemorates something that has unfortunately happened far too often in jazz music. I should just say music in general. That is, the person who puts together the music running away with the money. And so we've heard about stories of managers and all these kind of things, promoters, all of that kind of stuff. So of course, Dizzy encountered this many times in his career. But on his orchestra's first European tour, the tour was put together by a Swedish promoter named Harold Lundqvist. And they went over there in 1948 and did a number of successful dates. But of course, Harold Lundqvist started to get a couple of extra fingers on his hand, and things started missing. So much so that Dizzy Gillespie took to sleeping in the hallway of the hotel to make sure that he didn't creep out in the middle of the night. So after they came back, the great, Dizzy's great collaborator, who really orchestrated the sound of those his early big bands, his name was Walter Gil Fuller. And Gil Fuller wrote a piece to commemorate this whole, all of these happenings, and it's entitled Swedish Suite.
We'll be right back. Kenny Rampton on guitar.
And all that alto saxophone, and the person I'd like to turn it back over to, Ted Nash.
We're going to continue with another Dave Brubeck composition that I also arranged for the band. This one is from his album called Time In, a follow-up to Time Out. And this one is a waltz, and it's a, you know, just, it was a waltz, it was just optimistically going about his business, and everything was cool, and then something happened, and he just became a 4-4 swing. I don't quite what happened, but just kind of took over. So that's what happens in this piece called Lost Waltz.
Thank you.
Helen Mazzola, baritone sax player. Ryan Kaiser on the cornet. Chris Crenshaw on the trombone. Thank you so much. I'm going to pass it back to Chris.
Well, this orchestra was founded with surviving members of the Duke Ellington Orchestra, the Count Basie Orchestra, and the Thad and the Mel Lewis Orchestra. And there's such a continuum in jazz, and there's a generation before us, a generation before that, there's a generation after us, and knowing that, you know, it's gonna be left in good hands with musicians like Chris Lewis and Dias Armenteros, and so many others, it leaves us with hope and just optimism and everything that's included in that. And an alumnus of this orchestra and the Duke Ellington Orchestra played from 62 all the way to 1969, is a trombonist that was very, very extroverted, and his personality very gregarious, and it came out in his horn. And I'm talking about George Buster Cooper. You see, this is enthusiasm. It's, he gave you exactly that. Every time we were near St. Petersburg, Florida, he would always come to a show of ours and greet us in that same exact manner. And we're going to play a tune that was featured for Buster Cooper, as Duke would like to do with a lot of his members of his orchestra. And it's called Trombone Buster. It's based on the rhythm changes, I Got Rhythm, George Gershwin. And another title for this that they came up with while they were on a European tour was Trombonio Bustoso Issimo. But if you like Trombone Buster, we'll go with that too. And we're gonna feature on trombone Mr. Elliot Mason. Elliot, Mason, trombone, Obed Calvet, on the drums. One more time for Elliot Mason, trombone. So for our final composition, which has four movements in it, and feel free to clap between movements, after all, this is a jazz show. This one was a commission that Duke wrote back in August 1st, 1958 for the Great South Bay Jazz Festival out in Great River, New York, on Long Island. And they did it again at the French Lick Jazz Festival a few weeks later, and then they did the same suite, and it was actually called the Great South Bay Suite, and then when they did it at the French Lick Jazz Festival, they changed the name to Two Suite. Well, it was a jazz festival suite, and then they changed it to Two Suite. And they played the Two Suite at the Plaza with the Buck Clayton Trio, with Billie Holiday and Miles Davis Sextet. Y'all might know that album, Jazz from the Plaza, Volume 1 and 2. And they also, once they got it together really, really well, they recorded it as a part of an album called The Jazz Party. And it also featured Dizzy Gillespie playing UMMG, Billy Strayhorn tune, Upper Manhattan Medical Group. Played that, and this tune, like I said, has four movements, all different, but they're all good. The first one is called Red Shoes. No, the first one is called Red Garter. Red Garter. Very imaginative groove from the drums. And second is called Red Shoes. It's fast moving. It features Chris Lewis on clarinet and Wynton Marsalis on trumpet. And the third movement is called Red Carpet. And it's a slow blues. And it's very grandiose. And the final one is actually an excuse for Duke Ellington to put in the wailing interval that happened in 1956 at the Newport Jazz Festival that got everybody going and jumping and dancing and kind of revived jazz. And it's going to feature Dias Armenteros on tenor saxophone. It's called Ready Go. So we'll go in that order. And like I said, feel free to clap between movements. Thank you.
Thank you.
Quentin Marcellus on trumpet. Chris Lewis on clarinet. Thank you.
Marcus Crill.
I mentioned earlier that jazz is in good hands with our young generation coming up. Well, sitting in on drums is a man out of Portland, Oregon. Young man that's been touring with us on and off. And he's gonna join us on this last one, Ready Go. He's also features at Dias Armentero, so recent Juilliard grad. That's master's from you, right? Yes. So welcome to the family. But on drums, Damo Branch.
Thank you. Trouble Prince, still with us on the drums.